Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to reduce the power consumption of your Windows 11 PC. You might want to know how to do this to make your PC more energy efficient to lower energy costs. We'll have a number of different methods to try, so feel free to pick and choose which you think might work best for you. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. We'll begin with a quick test to see if there are any power issues that could be causing our PC to use more energy than it needs to. To do this, we're going to run the Power Troubleshooter. This can be done by going to the main settings page, and once in there, click on System from the options on the left side, although you should be in there by default. In the system settings, click on Troubleshoot, and then choose Other Troubleshooters. Now look down the list for the troubleshooter called Power, and click on Run next to it. Allow Windows to look for and suggest any possible solutions that might help. The next method is to turn on Power Saver mode in the Power settings. This is different to Battery Saver mode as it will run all of the time. You shouldn't notice too much of a performance difference, but it should lower energy usage as your components won't be working as hard. To change the Power settings to Power Saver mode, you need to go to the control panel first. You can get there by searching for it in the search bar. In the control panel, click on System and Security, and then choose Power Options from the list. In the Power Settings, you might need to click on Show Additional Plans to get the Power Saver option. Check the box to the left of Power Saver to turn it on. You can always choose Balanced if you are already on High Performance, so you don't lose too much performance whilst using less energy. If you click on Change Plan Settings, you can edit the time your PC will stay on. Whilst we're in the Power Settings, we'll move on to the third method. You can skip this one if you like, if you don't feel comfortable in changing some of these settings. If you are still in the Edit Plan Settings page of the Power Saver mode we selected, then click on Change Advanced Power Settings to open a new window. In these Advanced Settings, first find the option called Sleep and click on it to expand it. There are a few more options that we can change in here, such as turning on Hibernate. Now find the option called Processor Power Management and expand it, and then find the option called Maximum Processor State. Feel free to change this number to something like 80% initially. This will limit your processor to 80% and will save energy, but you will lose some performance obviously, especially when running demanding programs. So if it's not worth it, then you can return to here to change it back to 100%. If you find that 80% doesn't make much of a difference to the performance, then you could even go lower to save more energy. Remember to click Apply to save any changes that you've made. Next, it's worth checking for any Windows updates. Older versions of Windows 11 might have compatibility problems, or newer versions could have performance and efficiency upgrades. To update your PC to the latest version of Windows 11, first go to the main settings page. You can get here by searching for it. In the settings, click on Windows Update from the options on the left side. In here, simply click on Check for Updates and install any that appear. Remember to save any work before updating. The fifth method to save energy on your Windows 11 PC is to prevent certain apps from running when you start up your PC. Not only will these apps cause your PC to take longer to start up, but they will run in the background, which will result in your PC having to do more work than necessary. To view and disable startup programs, you first need to go to the Task Manager. You can get there by right-clicking on the Start Menu button at the bottom, and then by choosing Task Manager. In the Task Manager, find the Startup tab, and now you should see the list of programs that can automatically start when you turn on your PC. You'll need to go down the list and look for any programs you know you don't use, or those that you don't use regularly. Disabling them in here won't make them stop working, however they might take a bit longer to run when you want to use them. But of course, if you don't use them that often, this won't make too much difference. To disable an application in here, all you need to do is right-click on it, and then choose Disable. It's helpful to look at the Startup Impact column to help make your decision on whether it's worth disabling them. You can always enable the program again by right-clicking on it and selecting Enable. Whilst we're in the Task Manager, you can also save energy by closing any programs you aren't currently using. It's helpful to check which use the most system resources in the Processes tab by looking at the CPU and GPU column. Also, look in the Background Processes section for any apps that you don't use, but don't end the task though for any programs you don't recognize, as they could be system services. You might find things like your browser run in the background, and this will use unnecessary power. The seventh method to save energy on your PC is to make sure Bluetooth is turned off if you have it, as well as turning off Wi-Fi when not using it. Although this might be rare, if you really need to save energy, turning these off will help. Thankfully in Windows 11, it's easy to turn off Bluetooth. All you need to do is go to the main settings page, which can be accessed by searching for it. In the settings, you can turn off Bluetooth in the Bluetooth and devices section, and you can turn Wi-Fi off in the network and internet section. The next method is quite simple. All you need to do is unplug any peripheral devices from your PC when you are not using them. Any device, such as a wired printer or a USB hub, might draw unnecessary power from your PC, so if you keep them unplugged when not in use, you should use less energy. It won't make a massive difference, but it could help. Method 9 is to free up space on your device. If your device is close to capacity, it might run slower and therefore use more energy. Freeing up space could help make your PC run more efficiently. Check out my channel or click the card on screen now, as I'll have videos that cover many ways to free up space in Windows. A few quick ways to free up space would be to empty the recycle bin, which can be done by right-clicking on it. You could sort through your downloads folder or uninstall a program you no longer use. You can uninstall a program by going to Settings, then Apps and Features, and then finding the app you want to uninstall, and then finally, click on the three dots icon and choose Uninstall. The final method is to focus on the physical elements of your PC. This can be anything from ensuring your PC is running cool by cleaning dust and ensuring the fans aren't covered, or it could be by improving the hardware, such as upgrading to an SSD from a hard drive, as they will be more energy efficient. And so those are my methods to help lower the power consumption of your Windows 11 PC. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you how to improve the sound quality of your headphones in Windows. Help support the channel by visiting the store. The link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below. And if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.